Dear friends, we are gathered here today at this hour to witness and to celebrate the drawing together of two separate lives. We have come so that Jon and Cherie may be joined in marriage. It is not to be entered into lightly, but with certainty, with mutual respect, with a sense of respect and reverence which does not preclude joy. Love is one of the highest of human experiences. At its best, it reduces our selfishness, it deepens our personalities, and it makes life far more meaningful. Marriage symbolizes the ultimate intimacy between a man and a woman. This closeness should strengthen each partner in the bond of marriage. Today's celebration of affection is therefore the outward sign of a sacred commitment that they made to each other. In this spirit, Jon and Cherie stand before us today. Please be seated. Jon and Cherie, I ask you now to declare your intention to enter into this covenant together. Will you have each other to be wife and husband, to share in life, and to be together through times of joy and sorrow, plenty and want, of certainty and doubt, to accept the challenges and the unknown, overcoming your weakness through the strength of this union of love, so say we will. And I ask all of you gathered here today to pledge your commitment to support them both in their marriage, to be there for them, to answer those late night phone calls, to love them and to support them. If you commit to do that, please say, we will. Jon and Cherie have chosen two readings today. First one comes from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Love and long-suffering are kind. Love is not jealous. It does not brag. It does not get puffed up. It does not behave indecently. Does not look for its own interests. Love does not become provoked. It does not keep account of the wrongs. It does not rejoice over unrighteousness, but it rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The second comes from 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 8. It says, above all things, have intense love for one another, because love covers a multitude of sins. And so it is that we are here today. I have the honor and the privilege of being able to perform my cousin's wedding ceremony today. I'm very thankful for that gift. Thank you, Cherie. Jon, seeing her face light up when you are around, seeing the comfort and the strength that she gets from you is a great gift as well. And I thank you for providing that for my cousin. You're a good man. Today you guys are making a promise to each other. And it's a big one. And you're making that promise. You're choosing to do that promise today in front of all these people that are gathered. You chose these people to be here today because you know that they love you. You know that they support you. You know that they will get crackers for you 3 minutes before the wedding is about to start. You know that they will help with children who do not seem to be settling down the way that you had hoped. You know that these people love you, and they are glad to be here today for you. You know, I've told you some things about my life. I've been married twice. It didn't work out quite the way I had planned the first time. Love doesn't always work out that way, does it? But today, I think you guys have figured some things out about life. You've lived a little bit more than I did my first time around. You understand that the test of love isn't whether or not you guarantee you, if you allow them, those things will be the things that endear you to one another. The way he puts his smelly feet up on the coffee table after he's been hunting all day. Yes. Oh, honey, I love you so much. Thank you for providing for a family. Those are the things that can make your love grow and become richer and deeper. You know, I've learned a lot about being married, a lot. Not all of it was conventional wisdom that was given to me. I've learned that what goes around may actually come back around. I've learned that you can keep going long after you know you can't. I've learned that we are responsible for what we do no matter how we feel. The next time you're in a fight, remember that. Just because you're angry doesn't give you the right to be cruel. I've learned that money is a lousy way of keeping score. I've learned that my best friend and I can do anything or nothing. We have the best time. I've learned that sometimes, no matter how good a friend is, they're going to hurt you every once in a while. And you have to forgive them for that if you want to stay friends. I've learned that it isn't always enough to be forgiven by others. Sometimes you have to forgive yourself. I've learned that just because two people argue, it doesn't mean that they don't love each other. And just because they don't argue, it doesn't mean that they do. I've learned that two people can look at exactly the same thing and see something completely differently. I've learned that even when you think that you have no more to give, when your husband, when your wife, out to you, you will find the strength to help. I've learned that you must remember to put the seat back down. One time, 2 o'clock in the morning, that's all I'm saying. I've learned that the test of your love for each other is a sweaty hug and a morning breath kiss. I've learned that going to bed angry is not wise because you will wake up even more angry and sometimes not even remember why. I've learned that there are no guarantees. And that you have to work every day at marriage. And like everything that is worth something, everything that is precious, if you work at this thing, it will be good. I've learned that yes, dear, are two words which can save your marriage. And I've learned that the words I'm sorry are two words which will save your marriage. You know, guys, ultimately this thing about marriage is all about serving each other. Some days you are going to be on the road for quite a long time, doing hard jobs. And you're going to come home exhausted and tired. And you're not going to feel like doing much of anything for anybody, but you're going to walk in and see tears in your eyes for some reason. And at that moment, that's the test. You know, a few years back in Special Olympics, there was a running race. And all the contestants with their special needs lined up to take, you know, to take off and run as fast as they could. The gun fired and they kind of hobbled off and got going. And after just a few feet, one of them fell down. She started crying. And one of the contestants noticed and stopped the rest of the runners and said, "Wait." And they all turned back and they walked to that young lady that had fallen. And she bent down and gave her a kiss and said, "This will make it better." And then they all helped the girl up. And then they linked arms together. They forgot to let go. And they finished that race together. And there was a standing ovation that day. That lasted for minutes. Nobody cared who won that day because everybody won that day. And that's what you all need to do for your marriage. When something happens, when his work has been rough for him, and the boss is coming after him hard, and he's having a rough time, will you go back to him, give him a kiss, and tell him it'll be okay? When she's had a rough day and kids aren't listening, she's crying. come to that portion of the ceremony that is the big part. You all ready? Yeah. I invite you to face each other. I want you to look in each other's eyes. You can't look at me. Cherie, repeat after me. I, Cherie, take you, Jon. To be my husband.
To be my husband.
Forsaking all others. Forsaking all others.
Forsaking all others.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better and for worse. For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness or in health.
In sickness or in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part. I, Jon, take you, Cherie, to be my wife, forsaking all others, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness or in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. May I have rings. Wedding rings serve as an outward, invisible sign of an inward and invisible love which binds hearts together. As these rings are of the earth's finest materials, so love is of the richest of spiritual values. As the ring is without edge or seam, having no beginning and no ending, so they symbolize the perfection of a love that cannot end. May your marriage covenant be for you both a source of happiness and life-giving strength. Ladies and gentlemen, I now proclaim that Jon and Cherie are husband and wife. Let all people here and everywhere recognize and respect this marriage now and forever. Thank you.
Share with you the last bite of bread I ate. I will swim my own sea in your sea for me. And all your heart, let me show you what I mean.
Fulfilled. This marriage is now official. My friends, I introduce to you today Mr. and Mrs. Jon and Cherie. You may kiss each other.